Hey, Leo Dreger here. In this lab, I want to talk to you about WebSpy. WebSpy is kind of how it sounds, spying on web traffic. But I've actually also been able to use this as a denial of service tool. So I'll show you both. So the first thing we can do is basically a manual for WebSpy. And you can see displays sniffed URLs in Netscape in real time. Now, I think the trick here is that the Netscape component, if you use this with other browsers, it can basically result in a denial of service attack. So I'll show you that as well. So WebSpy sends URLs sniffed from a client to your local Netscape browser for display updated in real time. So if somebody else goes to the browser and on their machine, it opens up in your browser. But if you try to do this locally, basically an infinite loop happens, and that's where the denial of service is going to come into play. Netscape must be running on your local X display ahead of time, right? So you have to kind of set this up, your browser, and then send the WebSpy to the target. So that way, when they open theirs, when the traffic gets sent to you, you already have the tools to basically open it up. In other words, if your web browser is not open, the code is just going to get sent to you and then drop because you don't have Netscape basically open. So basically you set the interface, you can read the traffic from a PCAP file, process traffic from the PCAP file instead of on the network. So that's good for replaying and analyzing, and then specify the web client to spy on. Okay, so it's a relatively easy sniffing of the traffic, if you will. So let's go ahead and type in WebSpy. If you just type it, it'll basically tell you the quick help file. So all we need to do is choose our interface, WebSpy-I Ethernet 0, and then the host we want to actually spy on. So check this out. If we use our server here, 192.168.1.8, basically, we can listen for that server's traffic. Now, this gets hit or miss. So in this case, I'm going to try to sniff on a remote target. I'm going to go over to my Windows 2000 server, and I'm not using Netscape, okay? So let's just go ahead and search for Leo Dreger. Okay, comes over, and you can see basically nothing comes back on the target. But if we were using Netscape, this browser, this screen here, would basically, in our own client, get opened up. So just to kind of show you, if we were had a Netscape open, and you know we were at some page like Google, okay, and then you go to some other page on your target. So I'm going to just search again. The results would come back in here. But again, you have to use the right versions. Okay. So what I'm going to do now is change this up just a little bit to show you how to use this tool a little bit differently. And I'll show you how some of the processing gets used for this. Okay. So instead of doing a remote interface, I'm going to basically do myself. So first thing I want to do is check my IP address. So I'll do an ifconfig Ethernet 0. I'm on 192.130. So let's look at that. Let's do a WebSpy and then change that to 192.130. Okay, so I'm effectively sniffing myself at this point. And so WebSpy is running. Now here's the cool part. As soon as I open up any web page and go to something simple like leodreger.com, okay, it goes official site, not found here. But if you notice what's in the website, it says basically that I opened up this interface here. Not too exciting. Okay, I can prove that it sniffed, I prove that it works, and I basically get one open URL. But watch what happens when I go to basically a URL on a, let me rephrase that, on the destination. If they open up a web browsing session and they go to a site that has a whole bunch of links being processed in it, like for example gmail.com, now watch what happens over here. And that was probably a bad example. I did CNN earlier, so let's try that. There you go. Now you can start seeing some of the infinite loops that are happening. All right, so as it's trying to, one, read it from the target and then open it up in my own browser, I get this infinite loop that's happening until basically the web browser crashes. And then I have to kind of stop this, so I have to do this really quickly. I have to come back over and Control-C for it to happen. So Let's kind of scroll back to the top and see if we can't see what happened here. So what happens is in that session, you can say, I went to basically my website. I went to a basic website. And then as it's trying to relay the information back, here's all the CNN stuff, it's kind of fetching it from your target, grabbing it locally, adding it into your browser, which is supposed to be remote, and then goes and gets it and then adds it back in. And that starts this infinite loop. So effectively, what you could do is you could use this not only as a sniffing tool, but also as a denial of service tool because of the way that it handles the processing. And ultimately, all of the data is just going to get dumped right here. All those infinite loops and all of the proxy redirecting that happens that effectively cause a denial of service attack. So I thought that was pretty interesting just in the way that this tool just happens to work. Now, instead of my client browser opening, I actually, if you notice here, I can highlight this and actually click this in a open this up in the window. So it is clickable. It's not just terminal information, but you can click it. So it's a pretty cool tool. It is a sniffing tool. We're sniffing web requests, but we're also can do this remotely. And then we also, if we get strategic with it, we can set it up to run as a denial of service tool in an infinite loop. Now, for most of us, infinite loops haven't happened for some time. You may remember back in the day, you know, you'd go to a browser and it would start this infinite loop pop-up mess. And that was just a pain in the you know what. So if I go ahead and try to close out here, are you sure you want to close the 92 tabs? So effectively what I just did is denial of service myself just before the point of crashing, and I caught it just enough because it starts to get to 200 or 300. You can imagine how that would basically denial of service the system. So twofold here, one sniffing tool and then also reconfiguring it to use it as a denial of service tool. I'll just close out all the browsers at once, and then I can go ahead and you know take this captured output file, put it somewhere, do something with this traffic here. So the name of the tool was WebSpy. It can be used as a sniffing tool and as the denial of service tool if you set it to configure it basically correctly. So I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you in the next video.